Shalom, good evening.
Shalom. Shalom.
We are now in the Parashat Vayechi, the last parasha in the book of Genesis. Vayechi means live.
And he lived.
And he lived, Yaakov that lived. It means we talk really about the death of Yaakov. Really, it's we are in the. There are three parashot that we can say that they are going together. You know. Start with parashat Miketz in the end of 2 years. Right? Afterwards the Parashat Vayigash, and afterwards the Parashat Vayechi. Miketz is mean in the end, Vayechi mean living. So this give us association of Yitzchak, what is the letter of Ketz Chai. Ketz Chai. The letter of Yitzchak. Hmm. It means Yitzchak contain two concepts that we can say that Ketz, the end of the day, it's referred to the tree of Yehuda, equal Etz Yehuda, the tree of Yehuda, what is 190, what is 10 times Eve, what is the triangle of Eve, triangle of Eve, right? 1 plus 2 plus 3 until 19 equal 119, mm-hmm. Right? So it's a concept of Mashiach ben David, rectification of Eve, and Chai, the letter Chai, the letter 18, it's a tzaddik. You refer always to Yosef a tzaddik, to the tree of Yosef, to Jesus, etc. But really, we can reverse the thing because it is written Miketz. It means when you get to the end, the idea of Ketz Chai is that when you get to the end, you're reborn. Mm-hmm. It means it's like when you died, you're reborn. It's like Jesus said that who will find his soul, he will lose it. And who will give his soul for me, he will find it back. Hmm. Right? So you have the concept that the death is the root of the life.
Right.
And the life is the root of the death as well, I mean. Hmm. And Vayigash, you have the story of the connection of the two. Of the two trees, Vayigash Elav Yehuda, Yehuda go approach to Yosef, and will be the revelation of the two trees together, what we read in the Haftarah of Yechezkel, chapter 37, we read that in the future God will take the two trees and will make them one tree. Okay, so we see that the two trees have to do with the concept of Yitzchak. We can talk about Yitzchak as only Mashiach ben David, when we talk about the law, Yitzchak. And we can talk about Yitzchak like both of them together, when we talk about the high Yitzchak. Mm. Okay? Is David and is the root of David, the same idea. If I take the gematria of Mashiach ben David plus Mashiach ben Yosef in order number, Mashiach ben David, when I write David with you, plus Mashiach ben Yosef, in regular Gematria equal 1000. Right? We did this Gematria many times. What is Etsiuda or Ketz in big Mantzapar?
Right.
The tzaddik in the end of the world can be, instead of 90, can be 900.
Right.
And with the Kuf it's become 1000. The same thing about Etsiuda. So it's all, both together, it's the tree of Yehuda. Okay? And in order number, the two together equal Yitzhak. So it's all, so Yitzhak contains both of them. So in one way you will say the Yitzhak is a female, is Eve. In another way you will say the Yitzhak is both of them together. Okay? You can say they are both together because she got pregnant with the Mashiach. So she receives the male. And you can say that in the root, in the high Yitzhak, they are both together. Yitzhak born when Avram was 100 years old and Sarah was 90 years old. What is Ketz? It means when Avram and Sarah arrive to their Ketz, it means it's like they are like dead, they are very old. It is writing about the age of 100, Kilu Avadu Vatel Min Haolam. It's like he is not anymore in this world. Age of 100. And Sarah laughing, it's like she's completely in Olam Haba. She's Vatitzchak Sarah Bekirba. She laughing inside herself. But Bekirba it's like Berivka, the same letter. She laughing inside Rivka. Usually Rivka she's above Sarah, the way we put the model. Right? We have Rivka in the appearance of Sarah for the concept of the rabbi. So the Rivka is the Sarah, it's like the body, relative, and Rivka it's like the soul. And again, this we have Yitzhak in the appearance of Avram. Right? So you have Yitzhak with Rivka, and we have Avram with Sarah. Right? This is the way we did. After we have Yaakov inside Yitzhak, right? Mm-hmm. And after we have Esav inside Ishmael, right? We did it like the Aleph.
Mm-hmm.
We have Yitzhak in the appearance of Avraham, Rivka in the appearance of Sarah, Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzhak, Esav in the appearance of Ishmael. And this parallel to what, to in a more simple way, Esav, Yaakov, Vav, Yitzchak, Avraham. It's parallel.
Mm-hmm.
We have two models. All right, so Sarah, it's like she is, when she, her life, it's like she's dead. She's a soul inside Rivka.
Mm-hmm.
It's not Sarah that she's below. Sarah Bekirba equals Shorosh David. It means she's like Jesus, that she was sacrificed. When Yitzhak was sacrificed, mm-hmm. she died, she passed away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's like a revelation of the Mashiach that will born as Yitzhak, she laughing. Yitzhak, it means to laugh.
Mm-hmm.
He will laugh. Yitzhak, all right, she laughing, all right, she has a revelation of the Yechidah.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Rivka, she's connected, Sarah and Rivka, it's like the rabbi. How Rivka is connected to Yitzhak or to Yaakov? It is, Rivka will say, Katzti b'chayai. Katzti b'chayai. She's very upset about the marriage of Esau with a bad woman. All right, so she say
קצתי בחי מפני בנות חטא.
כן. I so I you translate קצתי בחי. It's קץ חי. קץ חי.
Yeah, I've become despised in my life.
Yeah, all right. So קצתי בחיי equal ישן plus ער.
Sleep and awake.
Any equal a triangle of Yehudi, triangle of 35, equal high 18 time a Jewish. It's in the triangle. Jewish is 35, the middle point of 35 is 18, so a number multiplied by this is middle point make a triangle, right? Yehudi equal tov, chai tov, live well, right? Chai tov equal 35 Yehudi. Yehudi. Chai square plus tov square equal tariag, the number of the commandment, 630. Okay? So if I do a triangle of 35, I will receive 630. What is katzti b'chayai? So about Yaakov, it is written how Yaakov is connected to Yitzchak. They are all connected together. The rabbi and the rabbi. The rabbi is Yaakov and the rabbi is Yitzchak. We call them Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzchak, both together. And they contain Sarah, Rivka, Yaakov, Yitzchak. It means it's all one type of personality, what refer to heaven. The other type of personality, it's Yitzchak. We have again Yitzchak. Yitzchak Avram. You see, we have two times Yitzchak. We have Yitzchak here. This is the high Yitzchak, Yitzchak Avram, and we have Esav Ishmael. The highest and the lowest. Right? So sometimes we call it Esav in the appearance of Avram, sometimes we call it Yitzchak in the appearance of Avram, in the appearance of Esav, in the appearance of Ishmael. It's like the two Yud in the Aleph. Okay, so about Yaakov, it is written Vayikatz Yaakov. Vayikatz Yaakov Mishnato. Yaakov wake up. So in one way, ketz is to get to the end, it's meant to die. But in the other way, it's meant to wake up.
Right.
All right? To wake up, it's meant living. It's like to be alive. So each one of the concepts contain is opposite. And when you say miketz, it's like you say when you get to the end, so then happens so and so. It's mean Yosef go out of the prison, it's like a body. In the prison it's like a dead, he's like a in a boor, he's not alive in this world. All right, so even we talk about the parasha of Miketz, we talk about the story of Yosef. And even we talk about the parashat Vayechi, we talk about the death of Yaakov. Yaakov is referred to the tree of Judah. Right, so it's very, each concept contain the two opposites. Each one of them is Yitzhak, Ketz Chai. Okay, so about Yaakov, it is writing Vayikatz Yaakov, and it is writing Vayechi Yaakov. What the passion of this week.
Yeah.
So again, we have Ketz Chai, that together equal Rivka Rivka. That like we said, she said Katsu B'chayai. 640, right? Mm. What is the opposite of Yitzchak Yitzchak? That is 460. Opposite number, right? We talk about this in the past. Okay, so we have Ketz Chai, we have Vayikatz Yaakov, Vayechi Yaakov. Again, the concept of the two opposite, how they refer to Rivka. And like we said, it is Sarah inside Rivka, but it's Chak Sarah Bekirba Berivka. Sarah laugh in herself. But in herself is the same letter of Berivka, inside Rivka, in herself.
Inside herself.
Inside herself. She laughs inside herself.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a laugh that is not revealed. All right, so this very general thing, if Yitzchak is Ketz Chai, what is Avraham?
Ever ma?
Yitzchak is a letter of Ketz and death life. Right? Looks like a Met Chai. Avraham is a Ketz Chen. So Chai is a male, Chen is a female, it's a couple. Chai plus Chen equal Chai plus Chen, it's like 18 plus 58 equal 76. Servant. If I multiply these two numbers, right, 18 times Chen, it's 1044. What is the name? Yeshua in symmetry, in filling letter. In when we have the Yud in the middle. It means the name that refers to the Chaya, to the Holy Beast. We have Ein, Vav, Shin, Yud, Shin, Vav, Ein. So we have the two eyes. Right? Yeshua. I equal this number, by the way. It means we have here the two concepts. So when you usually we say that Yitzhak is a female and Chai is a male. And Avram is a male, so why we have Chen? Chen is a female concept. It means Ketz, the end of Chen. When you get to the end of Chen, you become Chai. And when it means you become Avram, what is a male? The end of Chen refer to Chai, and the end of Chai refer to Chen. Because Yitzchak is the one that is the Chen personality. Right? Yitzchak is a female.
Right.
He's a woman. Right? So Ketz Chai, it means the end of Avraham is Yitzchak. The end of Yitzchak is Avraham. This is the idea. Okay? This is 208. This is 238. It's why Avraham equaled me Yitzchak. You had 40, right? Me Yitzchak, from Yitzchak. So Avraham came from Yitzchak. Before that Yitzchak came from Avraham. But we say, you know, you remember when we was talking about Parashat Toldot? Ve'ele Toldot Yitzchak ben Avraham. This is a generation coming from Yitzchak, son of Avraham. What are the generation coming from Yitzchak? Avraham. Olidet Yitzchak. Avraham that give birth to Yitzchak. Equal Avraham, Avraham, Yitzchak, Yitzchak. Avraham, Olidet Yitzchak. So it's a cycle.
Right. Intermerging with each other.
So in the Haftarah, we read about the union between the tree of Yosef and the tree of Judah. It's Yosef plus it's Yehuda. It's Yosef, tree of Yosef equals Jesus. Yes, 416. It's Yehuda equal Ketz. It means the end of the day, like we said before. Kids, 190. So together equal 506. What is the correction of the exile? Why we got to exile? We got to exile because Sinat Chinam. How you translate Sinat Chinam?
Baseless hatred.
Chinam is for nothing. There are many secrets with this word Chinam. Right? Chen Chinam equal Yosef. Chinam is like Zer Chen. חן, החן שלהם, חינם, זה חן of them. So, it's Yosef, what is the correction of שנאת חינם? אהבת חינם. Equal the tree of Yosef to the tree of Judah. Now, this equal show. Bull. Bull is Yosef. What about Yehuda? Why bull? Who The correction especially have to do with loving yourself. Yuda, it's a lesser problem. Right? Yuda, David, have a lot of people that don't like him, but still he was not lost from Am Yisrael. He was not... right? Mm-hmm. But we can't say that really, if we talk about the two concepts we want to bring back to Am Yisrael, is Jesus, that refers to Yosef, and is Esav. Both of them called bull. Our sages said, Shor v'chamor, bull and donkey, is Esav and Ishmael. And Esav refers to Mashiach ben David too, refers to the tree of Judah. It's a priest concept that is part of the concept of the tree of Judah, the priest, mm-hmm. priesthood. Right? It's Esav. So it's a bull too. So you have the concept of the bull is represented by the priest, but really Esav, we lost him. Mm-hmm. So there are two concepts that we have to love for nothing, for no reason, that we want to bring back to Am Yisrael, is Esav and is Yosef. Both we call bull. Mm-hmm. Right? So it's why we have bull as a, what else equals this? Shnei goyim bebitner. When Rivka was pregnant with Esav and Yaakov, she asked, what's going on? Why I suffer, why I have a... why the erayon is difficult. So they tell her, Shnei goim bevitner.
Two peoples in
it is, we say goim, but it is written Gijim, this way, with two yud.
Two nations.
You have two nations that fight, they are fighting there inside, so... this causes your problem. Probably the ones that call Esav cause the problem, because she said, Lama ze, why me? Anochi. Anochi is the number of times that that Esav wrote it, right? Writing in the Torah, what it means, me, ego, right? So.
Right.
The essence of the soul have to do with Anochi. Alright, so it is written, we come back to Yechezkel 37:17, you will make them close one to another. Lecha for you as a one tree. And they will be Achadim, once, right. In your hands. Achadim, it means few.
It's a plural one.
It's a plural of one, it's interesting. Achadim.
Means that they'll be one, but they'll still be distinct, individually.
V'hayu. They will be one in plural, in your hand. How much required? Yosef. Again. What about David? So if we analyze the number of letters we have here, we have here Dalet letter, after Vav, six letters, after again four letters. So if you count the letter, you have David letter in a structure of 4, 6, 4.
Right.
So we have David here too. Before this, it is written as Le'etz Echad, as one tree.
Le'etz Echad.
Le'etz Echad equal 173. What is the middle point of Moshe? Moshe is 345. We see that Moshe is like, it's like the priest is between the two trees. It contains both of them.
Right.
Usually we say that he's more close to Yosef. Mm. But it's really is both of them together. And the middle point of Moshe, it means 345 plus 1 split to 2 equal 173, what is a is the gematria of Galena, is the organization of my rabbi. Gal. And I reveal my eyes. Equal alpha v omega. This is prime number 41 is the secret of the DNA of Mashiach, the 41 generation, right from Abraham to Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
We refer them to the number from 41 to 41 square. In the past, we have a lesson about the Eldad and Medad that have the acronym of 41.
Mm-hmm.
Mashiach Eliyahu, Mordechai Esther, Eldad Medad.
Right.
Eliyahu plus Mashiach equal 10 times 41. Right. So this is the prime number 41. You know that this equal to Anochi, Hashem, Elokecha. 66, right?
Yeah.
I'm right?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the beginning of the first commandment, of the Ten Commandments.
Mm-hmm.
It starts with Aleph and it finishes with Mem. אנוכי השם אלוקיך אשר הוצאתיך
מארץ מצרים
מבית עבדים אחרי זה לא יהיה לך אלוקים אחרים על פניי
כן
עבדים מכל אורס אנוכי refer to Esav how many letter we have? 41 start with Aleph finish with Mem of עבדים it means we have the beginning. We have in the beginning and in the end, it's like from Aleph to Mem.
Mm-hmm.
And there are 41 Mem Aleph, Aleph Mem letter.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So you can parallel this letter to the 41 mm-hmm. generation. In the, okay? We parallel the Aleph Bet with with 28 letters from Aleph to Aleph to Thousand, we parallel them to the generation from David to Jesus. But here we have 41 letters, not 28, so we can parallel this letter to the 41 generation. Right, so we have to come back to the lesson we did a long time ago about the 41 family, how they refer to a series of prime numbers that start with 41, and the last one is not is a square of 41 and is not prime number anymore. But there was 40 numbers that was prime number, right?
Mm-hmm.
Start with Avraham, that's equal in order number 41. Right? Remember this.
Mm-hmm.
That his beginning and his end is 41.
Right.
So it's a big, very important number, 41. So when we talk about the concept of this number 13, hiding here the concept of 41, what is it's like the DNA of Mashiach.
Mm-hmm.
It's the two three together. One refers to Eldad, what is the Aleph, one refers to the Meidad, that is the Mem. One refers to Eliyahu, one refers to Mashiach.
Right.
One refers to Esther, one refers to Mordechai. Okay. One refers to Ephraim, another one refers to Menashe.
Okay.
One refers to Ariel, the other one to Menachem. So, it is mentioned four times in this chapter in the prophecy of Yechezkel, the concept of 13. How much is 4 times 173? 692. What is Esav plus Yeshu? Yeshu refers to Yaakov, right? It is a low Yaakov and it is a high Yaakov, like we said about Yitzchak, right? Because this acronym of, he called him Yaakov. This acronym of, they call him Esav.
Right.
So, an equal Talmid. Rav. Right?
Mm-hmm.
He's a disciple and the rabbi. The disciple represents Esav, the body, the bad inclination. The rabbi represents Yaakov, the good inclination, and equal Yitzchak. This is Ariel, Talmid, a disciple.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Me'aledet. You say Me'aledet, the same letter. A woman that helped to for the birth of baby.
Me'aledet.
She walking to to help the birth of Mashiach. Right, so this is the concept of the two nations, the two goyim that refer to Mashiach ben David, Mashiach ben Yosef, the tzir of Yosef, the tzir of Yehuda. In what other place we saw the tzir of Yehuda and the tzir of Yosef? When we write Mashiach ben David, we have inside Mashiach ben David
a midwife,
We have inside Mashiach ben David, we have Yeshu, what is equal to the tree of Yosef. And outside Mashiach ben Yosef, it means the letter around equal Etz Yehuda. It means the outside letter of the tree of Yosef is the tree of Yehuda, and the inner letter of Mashiach ben David, it means, is Jesus what is the tree of Yosef? Etz Yosef. Okay? Yeshu. Here we have Yeshu. Here we have the letter of the letter around Mem Chet Bet Nun Yud Pei that equal the tree of Yehuda. Now we say that it is written four times one tree, but the way it is written two times Etz Echad, and it is written two times Le Etz Echad. לעץ אחד בידיך. So, if we have before the number 692, we will add to this two lamed. If we want to calculate the way they are writing, the four times that it is writing one three, it is writing two times one three, and it is writing two times four. One tree. Le Etz Echad.
Into one tree.
Into.
Turn into one tree.
Two, yeah. So we have two letters of Lamed. So it's 60. So what we get? $2 million. If I just do the gematria of the parasha, we have parashat Miketz plus parashat Vayechi. Equal 230 plus 34. What is
264?
What is Seder?
Seder.
With the new order.
Mm-hmm.
If I do this with a big tzaddik. It means I count the tzaddik instead of 90, I count 900 the tzaddik, and the tzaddik sofi. I will receive 1074. What is Mashiach ben David with a big nun? What is three times Mashiach? So we have here a new order, three generation, or a free concept of Mashiach. So when you say Mashiach ben David, you contain all the free concept. Okay. Now if I add Vayigash, it gets plus. Vaigash. Vaigash, it means he go toward. Vaigash, I love Yehuda.
He approached him.
We're talking about these three parashot that we finish now in this week. We get Vaigash, Vayechi. There's this special connection of Yitzchak, of unite the two concepts of Yitzchak together.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So this equal 583 what is heaven, stone, 11 times stone. Heaven, it's one of the name of Mashiach, heaven, stone, father and son together.
Mm-hmm.
The father is in me and I am in him. Right?
Right.
The concept of Zayin Tikkuni Gulgulta, that the father is planted into seven different places in Arich Hanpin, refer to the seven letter of Yeshua in symmetry with the Ein in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Zayin Tikkuni Gulgulta. So the connection between the father and the son. So we have here, and if we separate, there's the letter of Yitzchak, Ketzchai, right? We have here the letter of Yitzchak,
right.
Ketzchai. The other letter equals Shlomo. So we have here Shlomo. It's like Shlomo is the peacemaker. The priest, Shlomo is the secret of the priest, is a priest maker between
Ketz Chai.
Between Ketz, what refers to the tree of Judah, and Chai that refers to the tree of Yosef. Yosef HaTzadik. Tzadik is the Chai letter, the 18 letters, so always Chai. Ever Chai is the concept of the Sphere of Yesod. We mention this two symmetric name. Yeshua, when we write it in symmetry this way, with the an in the middle, and Yeshua, when we write it in this symmetry with the yud in the middle. This refer to the dream of Paro. There are seven good cow. Seven good cow refer to the first coming, to the Yechida, to the first coming of Mashiach. And the Chaya, it will be dominant in the second coming of Mashiach, is the bad cow. And the bad cow, it's relative. Bad cow, it's like the body, relative to the soul. In the moment you reveal the body, you don't see anymore the soul. The soul is like, is inside, but we don't see it. It's not dominant anymore. Right? Like in this world. In this world, what is dominant is the seven bad cow. So relatively, this is the Yechida. This is the Chaya. It's like this is Mashiach ben David, this is Mashiach ben Yosef that is inside Mashiach ben David. The average value of these two names is 700. The average value, right? You take these two names together and you split it to two.
Mm-hmm.
It's 732. What is six times Tzlav? In all the permutations of cross. How does Gimetia refer to cow? Porat. Ben Porat Yosef.
Mm-hmm.
The son of the cow. Para, Porat. It's not referred to cow here, but it's the same letter of cow of.
Yeah,
ben Porat.
Cows.
All right, so you have 732. So you have here an end for cow. And in the dream of Paro, he dreamed after about the Shibolim. About the bed. How you say Shibolim?
Flat.
What you do?
Sheets.
What you do? The wheat with it.
Yeah, the bundles.
The bread.
Bundles of wheat.
Alright, so one is called shibolet. It's called the same thing. Right? So you have the int in Gematria of the two elements in the dream of Paro. And you know what equals this number? Seder Olami Hadash, new world order. It means you have the new world order of holiness. In one way it's three, in another way it's seven, if you do it in symmetry, right? Seder refers to Sus, Pered, Chamor, a horse, a mule, and a donkey. But they become seven, right? If you do it in symmetry, you write Sus. If you go from up to down, it will be Chamor, Pered, Sus, Chamor, Sus, Pered, Chamor. It will be like this. Chamor, Pered. Pered is referred to David, or the root of David.
Mm-hmm.
Referred to Jesus. It's both of them together. After you have Sus. Sus is a chaya. Inside the sus you have a chamor. After you have again sus. After you have pered. And after you have chamor. So you have a seder like this. And a reverse seder like this. And a donkey in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Right? This is the way we did it. We talked about this in the past. This is the seven head of the beast in holiness. Alright, so if you take this number, what is the average value of the seven letter here and the seven letter here, they're all connected together. So this refers to the seven head of the beast.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
These two number, two names together refer to the seven head of the beast in holiness. And the average value of these two name is Seder Olami Chadash, the new world order. So we have a new world order of holiness, we have the new world order of something else.
Right.
What else we call this number? Hatava Yarok, the green sign.
The green pass.
Tav, it's right. A sign, it's a mark. They don't. Mm. They don't call it a pass in Hebrew or a passport.
Right.
They don't call it passport. They call him mark.
Label.
Tav. Tav is a mark.
It's a label.
A tav, yeah. A yarok. Yarok, green, equals Jesus. So it can be a good thing. You know that it is written in the book of Yechezkel that God will sign on the head of the people of Jerusalem a sign. So our sages said that it is Tav Tichye, the first letter of Tichye is Tav, and Tav Tamut. So Tav, the letter Tav, that equals Yitzchak Yitzchak, if you write it with Yud. Tav. It's a sign. The letter Tav with filling letter.
Right.
Tav, it's a, in the ancient Hebrew, it's a cross. The way they used to do the Tav in the ancient Hebrew. Tav equal Yitzchak Yitzchak, Chen Mashiach.
Right?
416. And equal Lucifer, too.
Mm.
It can be a good sign. It can be a sign of the beast. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So, this is a sign. The way it is written in the In Yecheskel Tav, it is written this way. The way our sages write about this Tav, they write it with you. Tav Tichye and Tav Tamut. A sign that you will live and a sign that you will die. So
where does it say that?
In Yecheskel. With Veta, we talk about Yecheskel Tet, the ninth chapter in Yecheskel, verse 4. With Veta, it means you will mark Tav, a sign, on the forehead of the people of Al Mitzchot HaAnashim HaNe'enachim VeHaNe'enakim, Al Kol Tu'avot HaNa'asot Betocha. So you will write a sign on the forehead of the people that the suffering about all the bad things that people doing in he talk about Jerusalem. All right, so all the verse, it's interesting, all this verse equal David time Mashiach, 5012. 14 times Mashiach. All right, so this will be just the introduction, general introduction about the concept of Ketz Chai. We will continue with a second chapter that we will show all kind of example in the Bible of how this of this concept happened. You know, like Anivahu, one was killed, one stay alive about the master of the drink and the master of the bread that refers to the body and the blood of Jesus. Also, we will continue with this. We've got help with the next chapter. Thank you. Mm-hmm.